Hello, friends.
Welcome to episode 6 of our podcast, Kidsplorers. We're so excited that you're joining us on our journey to explore and discover new things. You might remember that in our last episode, we explored Stan Lee and Marvel Comics, the comic empire that he helped build. We hope you had a chance to follow along with us as we explored some of our favorite heroes and how they were invented. We love superheroes in our family, so it was really interesting to understand how the world of superheroes was created.
That's right. And this week I'm so excited that we chose another awesome topic.
Yes, we're exploring the Winter Olympics.
Yes, we are. I'm so excited to explore this topic with you guys. We really love watching both the Summer and Winter Olympic competitions in our family. We have been watching some of our favorite sports this past week because the Winter Olympics are actually taking place right now as we speak.
That's right. Some of my favorite winter sports to watch are curling and hockey. I love team sports a lot.
And I love watching figure skating.
That's also a beautiful sport. Hey guys, I have an idea. We love watching the Olympics, but we don't know much about how they started. How do you guys feel about paying a visit to Professor Smarty Pants at his lab to learn more about the history of these different competitions?
That's a great idea.
I agree. Are you guys ready to go?
Yes, to the car!
We're here so fast. I wish driving to Professor was a sport in the Olympics.
I can't see Professor Smarty Pants anywhere.
The door to his lab is unlocked. Why don't we check if he's inside?
Great idea!
There's Professor Smarty Pants.
Oh, hello friends. Did you come here to watch the Olympics hockey game with me?
This sounds so tempting, but no.
We actually came here to learn about the history of the Winter Olympics.
What a great topic. And you couldn't have chosen a better time. The Winter Olympic Games are taking place as we speak, and there are lots of incredible events scheduled.
We have watched quite a few of them, but then we got really curious about the history of the Winter Olympics. So we thought the best person to learn from is you. I love the Summer Olympics and Greek mythology, so I know how the Summer Olympics started, but...
Wait, I don't know this. Can you explain it to me?
Of course. This is one of my favorite topics of all time. The Olympic Games started in ancient Greece as a religious festival to honor Zeus, the king of all gods.
Wait, but the Olympic Games are a sporting event, not a religious event. I don't think I understand.
It can be confusing, but Daniel is right. The Olympic Games started in the year 776 before count in the town of Olympia in ancient Greece. It brought together the best of athletes to compete against one another. This event was so important that the ancient Greek actually based their calendar on how frequent these competitions were. In the case of the Olympic Games, they take place every 4 years. Today, the Olympic Games are known for different sport events. But back in the ancient time, people did not compete only in sport at these events. Can you guess what else people competed in?
Sleeping, snoring.
Ha ha, very funny.
I think I know this. Other than sports, people also competed in music, singing, and poetry. These were generally areas that many people were interested in ancient Greece.
That's right.
Hey guys, I want to tell you a funny story that happened in the Olympic Games in the year 720 before count. One Olympic athlete named Orsippius decided to take off his clothing and compete in the nude to be more comfortable when running. He also thought that competing naked would make him faster.
He ran naked? Ew!
That's right. Actually, he did run faster after undressing, which created a new tradition. From then on, all athletes in ancient Greece Olympics competed naked.
Very interesting, but I'm not sure that Winter Olympic athletes can compete without clothes today.
I agree. Since all Winter Olympic sports take place on ice or in snow, it would be quite silly for athletes to compete nude.
There are actually very serious rules about what athletes can wear during competition. If they do not dress according to these rules, they can be disqualified from the competition.
What does disqualified mean?
It means that the judges of the competition would not allow the athlete to compete in their sport because they did not follow the rules of the competition.
You're right. But let's back up a little bit. Unfortunately, with the fall of the Greek Empire, a new ruler took over Greece, the Roman Empire. And in 391 after count, the Roman Emperor Theodosius put a stop to the Olympic Games because the Olympics, as Daniel mentioned, were also a religious celebration. Since the emperor was Christian, he felt that no other god should be worshipped and canceled these events.
It took 1500 years for the Olympic Games to resume in modern day. In the year 1896, with the help of Pierre de Coubertin, the founder of the International Olympic Committee, the Olympic Games resumed. And you won't believe where they took place first.
In Greece?
That's right. They resumed in Athens, the capital of Greece. But you might wonder why we're not mentioning the Winter Olympic Games yet. After all, that's the topic of this week.
Well, the Olympic Games were always traditionally summer sports, like athletics, swimming, triathlon, and more. When the Olympic Games resumed in 1896, no winter sports were included. Over time, however, people started talking about the need to include winter sport in the Olympic. In the 1920 Olympic Games, two winter sports were included in the Summer Olympics, figure skating and ice hockey.
But then the people realized that the Olympic Games still excluded a big group of winter sports. So in 1924, the first Winter Olympics competition was held in Chamonix, France. The games included bobsleigh, curling, ice hockey, skiing, figure and speed skating, and a strange sport called military patrol race.
You might also be surprised, but in the first Winter Olympics, out of a total of 258 athletes, only 11 were women. This is mostly because women were not allowed to compete in many sport competitions at the time, simply because they were women. It took many people fighting for women athletes' rights and many years to achieve this, but as of the year 2007, the International Olympics Committee agreed that women must be able to compete in every sport.
That's amazing!
I agree. Well, today both the Summer and Winter Olympics Games take place every 4 years, but they alternate every 2 years. So for an example, the Winter Olympics will happen, then in 2 years the Summer Olympics, and then in 2 years the Winter Olympics happen again, and it continues like this. The only time this changed was last year because of COVID-19 restriction.
That's right. Because of COVID-19, the Olympic Games were delayed by a year to ensure that the Games could be held safely to minimize possible threat to participants and organizers. This also meant that a very limited audience was allowed in the Games, unlike all previous Olympic Games.
It's also important to note that the Olympic Games are hosted by different cities and countries each time. The International Olympic Committee chooses which city will host the next Olympic Games. So far, the United States hosted the Olympic Games 4 times, which is more than any other country.
Did you know that no countries in the Southern Hemisphere have ever been selected to host the Winter Olympics?
What is the Southern Hemisphere? And why did they not host the Winter Olympics?
The Southern Hemisphere is the area of the world south of the equator. This usually includes countries in South America, Africa, parts of Asia, and Australia.
This meant that the Winter Olympic Games were only held in North America, Europe, and Asia.
That's right. And the reason why no countries in the Southern Hemisphere hosted the Olympics is quite simple. It's too warm, sometimes even too hot there.
I get it, there isn't any snow there.
Exactly.
So what is happening this year with the Winter Olympics?
So much. This year, the Winter Games started on February the 4th, and they are taking place in Beijing, China. Beijing is the first city to host both the Summer and Winter Olympic Games. The Games will run until February the 20th, and then, starting on March the 4th to the 13th, the Winter Paralympic Games will take place.
What are the Paralympics?
The Paralympics are Olympic Games in which the athletes that compete have different disabilities.
What started as a sporting event with only a few sports, with mostly male athletes, has become the biggest sporting event in history, in which a very large number of athletes can compete, no matter their gender, age, race, or physical abilities. This is fantastic.
I agree. This is what makes the Olympics much more interesting.
That's right. Well, this year, 2,871 athletes are competing in 15 different sports disciplines. Of these disciplines, only 4 sports will be held indoor. Can you guess which ones?
Hockey, curling, speed skating, and my favorite, figure skating.
That's right. Good for you for knowing this. The other disciplines are outdoor sports, and they are the biathlon, bobsledding, curling, and skiing, which also include snowboarding and ski jumping.
I know another interesting fact. The country with the most athletes in the Beijing Olympics is America. They have 224 athletes competing. Canada is in second place with 215 athletes competing.
Very interesting. While all the competing athletes will have to compete in a different way than in previous years. Similar to last year's Summer Olympics, the Beijing Games have many health safety measures which are related to COVID-19. One of the measures is that athletes need to be tested regularly for COVID-19. Only those with a negative result can compete in their sport.
That's a smart idea.
I agree, Isabella. I know that you love animals. Did you know that the mascot for the Beijing Winter Olympics is a panda?
What is a mascot?
A mascot is an animal, person, or object that brings luck to a sports team. At our school, our mascot is a lion. For the Olympics this winter, a cute little panda was chosen as the mascot. His name is Bing Duan Duan. Bing means ice and strength, and Duan Duan means children.
Very cool. I also heard about the Olympic rings. What are they?
Good question. The Olympic rings are the official logo for the Olympic Games. They represent different continents and athletes coming together for sports.
I love that logo. Whenever I see it, I get in the mood for watching sports competitions. When I was little, I dreamt of being an athlete in the Olympic Games.
No way. Well, you would have had the best chance of winning if you were from Norway. Did you know that Norway has won the most gold medals since the Winter Olympics began?
Really? How many?
They won 350 gold medals. The most successful Norwegian Winter Olympian is Bjørn Dæhlie. He won 8 gold medals and 4 silver medals in the sport of cross-country skiing.
That's incredible. So what happens when the athlete wins a competition?
Well, when all the athletes in a sporting event finish their competition, the 3 athletes with the best results are awarded medals in an award ceremony. Athletes in first place, who achieve the best score, are awarded a gold medal. Athletes in second place are awarded a silver medal. And athletes in third place are awarded a bronze medal. Once they receive their medals, the flag of the country for which the gold medalist competes is raised and the country's national anthem is played.
I love watching the awards being presented to the athletes.
Me too. Mommy, Daniel and I have the funniest Winter Olympics story to tell you.
I'd love to hear it.
In the 2002 Winter Olympic speed skating competition, the least likely athlete won the gold medal. Stephen Bradbury was an Australian speed skater who was competing against some of the fastest speed skaters of the time, but they all lost to him.
No way. How did that happen?
They all crashed and fell except him.
Because they all fell, he was the first one to make it across the finish line. This is how he got a gold medal.
What a good lesson on why you should never give up.
Absolutely. All the athletes who are competing in the Olympic Games have incredible skills and talents that they work very hard for. We're very proud of our Canadian athletes and wish them lots of luck in all their competitions.
Good luck!
Wow, I learned so much about the Winter Olympics today.
Me too. I feel like we learned everything we could about these amazing games. Thank you, Professor Smarty Pants, for sharing your knowledge with us.
It's my pleasure. I also learn a lot from you guys.
I agree. Well, Mommy, Isabel and I were talking about what we could explore next week and realized that we're both learning about a very important topic at school this month.
It's so nice to see you guys excited about what you're learning. I'd love to know more.
Mommy, did you know February is Black History Month?
Oh yes, this is such an important topic. I'm so happy you guys are learning about this.
We are also interested in learning about this, that Isabel and I were wondering if we could explore more about it next Sunday. We would love to learn about some very important and brave Black people who have done and are still doing a lot of very important work to make sure that Black people live in a just society.
I really appreciate that you guys want to explore this topic. It's so important to learn about how we can create a community in which all people feel safe. Friends, join us again next Sunday as we explore more about Black History Month. I really look forward to it. We really hope that you liked today's episode. We would be so excited if you could share our podcast with all your friends who you think would like to join us on our explorations. We always look forward to hearing from you about any feedback or suggestions for what you'd like us to explore in future episodes. In the meantime, if you liked our episode today, we will be so excited if you could give us a 5-star review on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or any other platform that you listen to us on. It will mean so much to us. And this is it, the end of our 6th episode.
Thank you all.
Until next week, goodbye.
Hey guys, want to watch?